His fighters will not lay down their arms until Iraq is free of foreign troops. U.S. forces continue to strike followers of terrorist leader Abu Musab al-Zarqawi, dropping 6 bombs on a home believed to be a safe house in Fallujah. At least 10 people were killed in the attack, with an untold number of injured. Joining us now for a closer look at all of today's significant developments inside Iraq is Rahed Adragam, MSNBC analyst and senior diplomatic correspondent for Al Hayat newspaper. Thanks for being with us. Let's start with this controversial amnesty plan being considered by the new Iraqi government. Why are they even considering it?
Because I think the Prime Minister wants to send a message to the Iraqis to say this is a sovereign interim government and it is an encompassing government, and wants to make a distinction between these groups such as the Al-Mahdi Army and Muqtada Sadr and the terrorists at large. So I think in his attempt here is to say, yes, we will give amnesty, but you join us in peaceful resistance, if you will, peaceful opposition, but make a distinction and try to go for the Iraq priority rather than any other priority, including the war on terrorism priority.
Now, as we just reported, Muqtada al-Sadr may be doing away with his truce deal. How political do you think he is in his motivation?
Actually, we even heard afterwards one of his people saying, in fact, no, he is not backing down. This is not a call to take arms. They are speaking, to use their words, peaceful resistance. So it's conflicting messages we're getting. And I think it's because of negotiating what would he have of guarantees should he dissolve his militia, and what sort of a place would he have in the political map. I think he is, of course, not as powerful as Ayatollah Ali Sistani, the Grand Ayatollah, but he's trying to make himself a matter in Iraq. And the point is that I think there should be an opening, exactly as the Prime Minister is doing, to try to say come in rather than let's fight them.
Do you agree with Colonel Jack Jacobs about his credibility among the new Iraqi government? He says they're afraid of him.
Afraid of Muqtada al-Sadr?
Yes.
I don't think so. I think they have, if they have somebody like Ayatollah Ali Sistani to their side, I don't think they're going to be afraid of Muqtada al-Sadr, except if Muqtada al-Sadr is driven to have an alliance with the other insurgents, if you will, who are not Iraqis. And there is a very big difference between the two sort of shades. You know, Muqtada al-Sadr is not considered a terrorist by the Iraqis. He is someone who wanted to fight occupation. And now the interim government is saying, fine, there are ways to really make sure we don't have any more 160,000 troops on our land. So join in and let's make this work. I don't think it's a matter of fear. And the Prime Minister, in a way, he wants to establish his credentials of power, but I don't think he is an unwise man. He's going to exhaust the diplomatic channel before he goes the other way.
We have also been talking about some of Saddam's cousins reportedly feeding money, supplies, people from Syria and Jordan to help in Iraq's insurgency. Can you tell us some more about this?
Well, I don't think this should be surprising at all. This is the same clan who benefited, who are the greatest beneficiaries actually, from the tyranny of Saddam Hussein. They are not embraced by the Iraqis because they're associated with that tyranny, be it its face and its arm. So I think they may resort to the insurgents outside of Iraq in order to get their agenda going. And I believe maybe they were emboldened recently by seeing Saddam Hussein when he was arraigned in a way that all you needed was to give him a cigar and he'll be his good old self again. And so I think they were emboldened by his good old ways of intimidating, and they wanted to bank on that. Neighboring countries will have to stop any aid coming through this clan, the Tikrit clan, otherwise I think it's going to be problematic for these neighboring countries.
We do want to get your reaction to some of this highly produced video that we've received by Zarqawi's organization looking for some new recruits. Do you think Iraq now has become the haven for terrorists, the very thing the U.S. went to war to stop?
Well, you see, the argument is that, in fact, terrorism came to Iraq after the war and not before the war. Certainly there was tyranny of Saddam Hussein, but there was no terrorism as such. And I believe this is a mistake right now. It makes it very difficult for the interim government if it's told now you're going to be the forefront for the Iraq for the war on terrorism. And that is why I think President Bush is really not doing them a favor by saying we are engaging the enemies in Iraq and Afghanistan so that we take the war on terror away from our cities. And I think that the clarity of the mission of our troops should be to help the Iraqis restore Iraq. And that's the best ally in defeating terrorism in Iraq right now is very much the very Iraqi people. If they feel that they are not being used as pawns, if they feel this is really about their liberty, if they feel that this is a fight for their well-being, they'll be the best allies in fighting terrorism. But if they think that there are cheaper lives and being there to fight a greater war on terrorism away from American cities, we may not get their hearts and minds as we hope to.
MSNBC analyst Rohit Durgam, thanks so much for being with us. We appreciate it.
Thank you very much.